Rick said you got put on second team pretty early in practice yesterday. Just how did that motivate you, and what did you feel like you had going so well for you tonight?
You know, Coach Barnes, he always tries to push people, so he tried to, you know, kind of mess with me a little bit. So, you know, I mean, it was, I don't know what to really say about that. I mean, to be honest, he just tried to get at me, get me going in practice so I could play hard.
What did you have going for you tonight?
I mean, of course. I mean, I feel like I played pretty hard tonight. I mean, it was a great team win.
Jonas, after the way you guys lost the last two games, how do you not waver and be able to come out and play for 40 minutes like you did tonight?
Just staying confident. I mean, basketball, it goes up and down. I mean, there's been plenty of teams that have been knocked off the standings and stuff like that. So, you know, you just have to keep playing hard. Like, I keep talking about the second half versus Missouri. I mean, if we play like that every game, I mean, I feel like nobody can stop us.
Brandon Miller, what did you see from Jahmai when Jahmai was on him? And then from a team perspective, how were you all able to make life tough on him tonight?
Jahmai, I was talking to Jahmai like 2 days before the game. I mean, he was locked in. Like, he was super locked in. He was talking about he's not going to get nothing. He's going to play hard. I mean, we seen that. Like, he didn't ever score. He had the highest plus minus on the team. And then I feel like he did a phenomenal job on Brandon Miller. And for the rest of the team, we just knew if he got clipped on any ball schemes, we had to help him run him off the three-point line and just force him to take bad shots.
You guys didn't splinter after the last two games. You guys stayed together. What were the conversations like, I guess, coming off those losses, you know, in the locker room around the team?
I mean, it wasn't nothing too crazy. I mean, it was just talking about we just got to just play the game. Like, we just probably think too much and just do what we do. Just play hard. Like, I mean, I'm going to keep going back to the Missouri game. Just do that. The second half, we're going to be fine.
Sequence I wanted to ask you about, defensive play. I think maybe 3 minutes left in the game, you block a shot, and then it looked like two Alabama guys ready to get the rebound and have an easy layup, and you kind of knocked it off to a Tennessee guy. Just walk me through that sequence.
I mean, my job is just to protect the rim at all costs. I mean, if I see anything going on, I'm going to try and get it. I mean, just making those multiple effort plays that Coach Barnes talked about, that's what I'm going to try to do it every time.
Jonas, what was it like being out there in crunch time tonight? And for a guy who, I guess you were making your third start of the season, when you picked up your fourth foul late, that was one of the biggest, you know, moments of the game. What's it like going from a guy who, you know, plays 18 minutes a game to being one of the most important guys on the floor in a game like that?
I would just say being more confident, getting comfortable with the game flow. I mean, to be honest, I knew I had four, but it didn't even feel like I had four fouls. I mean, I'm just going out there playing defense, just doing what Coach telling me to do, to be honest.
Jonas, tonight's obviously a big win, but now you have a quick turnaround and head up north to face a rival. Just how do you all make sure you don't allow this to linger and affect Saturday's performance?
We can't get comfortable. I mean, anything can happen, so we just got to go in there and just fight. We got to get them back.
Obviously, Uros Plavsic is kind of a character. How much does he fuel you guys when he gets the crowd riled up during games like this?
Man, Rose, he brings so much energy. I love what he do, but sometimes, you know, he can get a little too crazy, but we love him for that. I mean, that's just who he is, and he's always going to get us hype every time.
All right. Anything else for Jonas? All right, Jonas, thank you very much, man.
Thank you. Thank you.